Hey there, welcome back to the Beginner's Guide to Python. And in this video, I'm going to explain how you use while loops. Before I show you how to use a while loop, I'm going to explain what a while loop is. So a while loop is a way that you can repeatedly execute a block of code while a certain condition is met. So you simply write while and then the condition, and then you put the block of code that you want to continuously execute until that condition is no longer met. Okay, so let's go ahead and create our first while loop. Load up your Atom editor to the project that we were using in the previous videos of this short course. So make sure you have the Beginner's Guide to Python project open, and let's create a new file. And we're going to call the new file while underscore loops.py. All right, so in our file, we're going to start by defining a variable, a number variable. Let's go with the theme that we've been following in the previous videos, and let's stick with the Apple theme. And let's create a variable called apples, and let's set that to a number equal to 10. Okay, so now let's imagine we want a piece of code that will repeatedly execute and tell us how many apples we have left and reduce the number of apples that we have in the stock. So let's type our while loop, type while, and then the condition. So we'll say while apples is more than zero, colon, and then under here, we put the block of code that we want to execute while apples is more than zero. So let's start by printing. We have, and then let's print the number of apples that we have. So let's put str and then plus apples. The reason we put the str here is so that we can convert the number variable apples into a string so that we can add it into our string here. If you were to just include apples, you would get a type error where it says you cannot concatenate an integer and a string together. You basically need to convert the number into a string using this str function that we have here. It's a built-in Python function. Okay, so now we have one more thing to do. We need to remember to reduce the number of apples each time this code runs. Otherwise, it will just run forever, because if nothing is deducting from apples, this will always be true and it will continue to run on an infinite loop and it may crash our application. So we're going to type apples equals apples minus one. Save that. And then under here, let's come back to the base indenting of the file and let's print we have no more apples. All right, I'm just going to expand this so we can see it. So I'm just going to explain what this does line by line. So it starts off by defining a variable called apples and assigning a number 10. So we have apples and we have apples equals 10. And then we have this while loop. So this checks if apples is more than zero. So is apples more than zero? Yes, because apples is 10. So what it does, it will, because this is true, because this evaluates as true, it will run the code in this block here. So it will do print, we have, and then the number of apples. And then this, it will come down to this line and it will take one away from apples. So apples now equals 9. Then the while loop will check again after it gets to the bottom. It will check again, is apples more than zero? If the answer is yes, if apples is more than zero, it will continue to loop round until apples is no longer equal to zero, then the code falls back to the regular thread and then it will continue to execute the lines below the while loop. So we're gonna get a repeated output until apples is zero and then it's gonna tell us we have no more apples. So let's go ahead, load up our command prompt or terminal window, navigate to the Beginner's Guide to Python directory, and let's type python while loops.py and hit enter. And there you go, you can see that the code has ran 10 times and then it got to the bottom and it said we have no more apples. You could refactor this slightly to use a shorthand here. So what you can actually do is you can, when you're just deducting a number from a variable, you can just put apples minus equals one, and this is a Python shorthand function that will basically just deduct one from apples each time. And it's just because taking deducting a variable or deducting a number from a variable is a thing that people do a lot in Python, so they created this shortcut to help you do it faster. We save that and you run and you'll see it will output the same thing. Okay, so that's how you use very simple while loops in Python. I hope you found this useful. If you have any questions at all, then please leave them in the comments below and I'll try and answer them, or maybe someone else will answer them for you. Thank you so much for watching and I will see you in the next video.